organization. So let's get started with today's ACCA F5 session, Shutdown Decisions. Now, the first situation that can come in a shutdown decision problem is where there is no alternative use. Assume that you are running a company where one of the product that is manufactured is designer cakes. The profit and loss account is also provided. The contribution from sale of cakes is $1,000. The rent of the oven is $200. The oven is exclusively used for making the cakes. The cake designer salary is $300. And you have an apportioned cost, that's a general staff salary, $300, and the apportioned factory rent amounting to $400. So the total fixed cost amounts to $1,200. So the net profit is $1,000 minus $1,200, leading to a loss of $200. Now, what we have to decide is whether we have to shut down the cake division. Now, in this particular case, just think for yourself. Even if you close down the cake division, we will still have to pay the factory rent. We will still have to pay the general staff salary, which means that those expenses will remain as such, even if we close down the cake division. So basically, we will have to redraft the P&L account to see what is the profit attributable only to the cake division. So it is very easy to redraft the P&L. The only thing that you have to eliminate is the general staff salary and factory rent. And why are we eliminating that? Simply because it will remain unchanged even if we close down the cake division. So we are just trying to find out what is the profit which is exclusively related to the cake division. So the redrafted P&L account will appear like this. Now, if you notice, the only two items that I have deleted is the general staff salary and the factory rent. And the rent of the oven I have included because it is a specific fixed cost. Oven is exclusively used for making cakes. And the cake designer's salary, $300, is also included because that is also a specific fixed cost. It's not a general fixed cost. So all that we have to understand is whenever we are redrafting the P&L account, only the specific fixed cost has to be reduced from the contribution. And the resulting profit that you get is the attributable profit. What do you mean by attributable profit? The profit exclusively related to the cake division. So if you see here, the attributable profit is contribution is $1,000 minus specific fixed cost is $500, resulting in an attributable profit of $500. It's a positive figure, which means that if you shut down the cake division, you're going to lose $500. So, since the attributable profit is positive, the decision is not to shut down the cake division. So, that is what I've written here. Decision is do not shut down the cake division simply because the attributable profit is positive. So, that was situation one where there was no alternative use. Now, we will go to situation two. Situation two is when alternative use is available. So we've got just two additional information. One is alternative contribution from the sale of spring rolls is $800. What does this mean? If we are stopping the cake division, then we could invest our time and resources for starting the spring roll division. And the contribution that we will get from the sale of spring rolls is $800. And the second point is redundancy payment to the cake designer is $100. Now, what do you mean by redundancy payment? Redundancy payment are those payments which are made to employees who are terminated or who are no longer required. Now, if we close down the cake division, then we don't need the cake designer, which means that he will be terminated. So we will have to pay him redundancy payment, which means that redundancy payment is a payment which you have to make just because of our decision to close down the cake division. So in such a situation, how would you decide whether it is better to shut down the cake division or not? So the first step is similar. That is, we have to redraft the P&L account by eliminating the general fixed cost. So that is similar to situation one. So we get an attributable profit of $500. Now, if we close down the cake division, we will definitely lose $500, correct? So what I will do is I will copy the redrafted P&L into the next slide. Now we will do our working. So if we close down the cake division, we will definitely lose the attributable profit of $500 because $500 is the profit exclusively related to cake division. So that's our first concern. So the lost attributable profit is $500. I have indicated it with a negative figure because we will be losing it if we shut down the cake division. What is the next item that we have to consider? If we close down the cake division, we can open the spring roll division for which we get a contribution of $800. So that's our gain. So alternative contribution gain is $800. $800 is nothing but the contribution that we get from the sale of spring rolls. What is the next item? Redundancy payment of $100. We have to pay $100 to the cake designer if we stop the cake division. So which means that that is also an expense or that is also a relevant cost. So closure cost. Closure cost example is redundancy payment or any other closure cost will come like any penalties that you have to pay. All those expenses will be compiled under the closure cost. So right now we have a closure cost of $100, which is nothing but the redundancy payment made to the cake designer. So that's $100. So that's also an expense. So I've indicated that in bracket. So what is the net gain if we close down the cake division and open the spring roll division? It is a net gain of 800 minus 100 minus 500, or the net gain is $200. So it's better to close down the cake division, right? So the final decision is shut down the cake division. Now, whenever we get a problem on shutdown decisions, the numerical part is what we have just seen. Now, think of a practical scenario where you close down your cake division. Maybe your reputation in the market will be adversely affected. So this is something that you have to consider before you shut down. So whenever you get a problem, always write your findings from the numerical data first and always add this point. That is, we should consider whether the reputation of the company will be affected if there is a shutdown of that particular division. This is a point that should be added with your answer. So here we come to an end of yet another topic of the ACCA F5 Performance Management paper. If you have benefited from the video, do support the channel by clicking the subscribe and the like button. And do stay tuned for similar videos. Thank you all and see you in the next video.